Name ist Chandra. I'm your host today and this is a new episode, How to Select Pumps. But before we get started, I would like to draw your attention to send us all your comments and questions either via chat function or via email. And if you like what we do, then you can support us via social media with your positive comments and positive ratings. And now I want to jump to our today's topics. So I want to switch off my camera in order to keep the connection good. So today we would like to talk about the main topics where we can support you. When the project starts to be more complex and probably as expected. That means this can be the phase where no action started yet, but the people think about new things, or the phase where already something happens. So this is the second step, the basic engineering or something like that. So, and in the third step, we want to show you some possible results of pump selections at the end. This brings me to the reasons why we do this today. So first of all, there must be a good reason to select pumps. That means there must be either a new idea where the operating company is thinking about new constructions or new buildings or new tunneling systems or mining systems, or there must be a new technical requirement which cause some kind of changes in existing installations, or there must be a new need due to continuous working progress on existing construction sites, or a new demand where a Tsurumi pump can be a substitution product for other kind of pumps. Pre-engineering also means that all those elements must be evaluated of feasibility before doing the next step in the project. How and what can Tsurumi do to help? Actually, we can be part of all feasibility elements, but our focus is more on the technical analysis and due to this also on the economic analysis by calculating realistic budget prices and possible solutions. Now I want you present a real and existing request we received from an engineering company from the south of Germany. This company asked us for a solution to pump seawater from the sea to a reverse osmosis plant to get the seawater desalinated. In the green rectangle, you can see the information we received. That was not really much. The static head is about 10 meters from the place where we install the pump. The distance between pump and the reverse osmosis plant should be around 3 kilometers, and the required flow rate should be 600 cubic meter per hour. And the medium is seawater. In that phase, what we really miss is the hood specification. We didn't get any further information, and we should know the piping material, diameter, all of the piping accessories, technical requirements, and code and standards. Now I want to illustrate what we can do even when we have limited information only. And of course, we start with our standard selection tool, Spikes. First, we enter all available data. What we have or what we can enter here is the 600 cubic meter per hour and to select seawater. Then we start to select the piping. Spikes recommended already a 10-inch piping. And here we can also see the flow velocity in that design is 3.4 meter per second, which is still quite high, but this is what have to be discussed with the operator, with the operating company or with the engineering company. Probably they need that high flow velocity or they can accept that high flow velocity. If not, then we need to select a bigger pipeline in DN300 or even bigger. The common flow velocity we always recommend to our customers is between 1.5 to 2.5 meter per second. But before we continue with the calculation, let's see the impact of different types of pipings on the design. So, and that is what we can see here. Even if we use pipes with the same inner diameter of 250 millimeters, and even if the flow velocity is the same, the quality and the piping material will cause different friction losses. This is what we can see here. If we use that kind of piping, the friction loss according to the selected or the entered pipe length is here 140 meter. If we use this kind of steel piping, only 116 meters. And if we use HDPE piping, then only a little bit more than 100 meter. So now we can continue our calculation. According to the entered data and the pre-selected piping, the system calculated a total delivery head of more than 150 meters. So now we can start to select pump via or by spikes. The result what we have is we need a pump which can handle a total delivery head of 150 meter and a flow rate of 600 cubic meter per hour. So, but we can see that actually Spikes did not select anything. And he also told us that check the flow rate and check the total head because we are, the Tsurumi range is out of his limits now. So, in this case, we are doing more calculation with different numbers as follows. So first we try to reduce the friction loss by reducing the distance of the pump between the pump and the osmosis plant. And this is already an indication that intermediate basins or booster pumps will be needed. So what we did is you can see here that the distance of 3000 meter we reduced once to 1500 to 1000 to 500 and to 100. And Spikes did not recommend any pumps. And that brings us to reduce the flow rate. So if we start to reduce the flow rate, but we keep the original pipe lengths, there is no result. Even if we reduce the pipe lengths to 1,500 meter, there is no result. When we reduce the pipe lengths to 1,000 meter, then we get the first and then we get also second recommendation from Spikes. So we do this calculation until Spikes will have recommendations. And by the way, this is also an indication that probably we need more than one pump to be connected parallel. After getting off recommendation, we start to check the system by looking for the duty point in a separate diagram. But before we looking for a duty point, one other comment to the possible applications. As I already mentioned, there is a possibility or an indication that parallel and series application will be needed due to that there is no pump which can handle the high delivery head and the required flow rate. Why we are thinking about parallel operation? Parallel operation will be used to increase the flow rate, and the series operation will be used to increase the total delivery head or to bridge longer distances between pumps and any kind of plants. So let's have a look to the duty point we have calculated. Actually, this is an example for the duty point by using of two pumps. In that diagram, we can see two parallel connected pumps with the performance curve for the first pump and for the second pump. And this is the performance curve we have for the calculated or for the selected piping. Of course, when we change the piping, the curve of the piping will also change. When we would use a smaller pipeline, then the curve will change in this direction. And if we would use a bigger pipeline also, even then, the curve will change in this direction. So this is a pre-selection in order to have an idea for the customer for his budget. So, and the solution for the existing request could be as follows. We realized that we need to connect two pumps parallel in order to handle the big amount of flow rate. And we need to have more than one pump to bridge the long distance between the osmosis plant. This picture shows you that in the first, we have two pumps connected parallel, and then the second pump station and the third pump station as well. But we want to use only one piping system to transfer the high flow rate. What we did not consider until now is a control system, as well as piping accessories like any kind of bends or any kind of valves and non-return valves, et cetera, because this is still not clarified. As I mentioned at the beginning, we are still waiting for the whole specification, but the engineering company has no prepared or did not prepare any specification until now because they are working on an idea. But this brings us to be able to create a ballpark figure for the engineering company in order to be judged the situation and to make the decision, is it possible to continue that project or not? The second step, what we do after finishing of the pre-engineering phase, when all budgets are approved from the operating company or from the engineering company or by the owner, to start with the with the clarification of the details. So what we want is to understand the whole process of the customer. And of course, we would like to find out more or as much as possible about the whole process. For that, we use a kind of sheet like Excel sheet like this. So where we try to enter all available information, we can select some kind of top fluids. We can enter special temperature ranges or density, viscosity, the pH value, Then we can talk about the operation mode, single, parallel, serial, or a backup operation. Then we need to consider the content of the solid particles in the medium, or what kind of medium we are discussing about. Then in regard of the electricity, is there a side power distributor, yes or not? Or is the operation with generator? Do we need a motor protection plug? How do we connect the pumps? All these questions could have an impact of the design and of course of, on prices. Then we want to think about, if I say we want to think about the whole system, then we want to consider the size of the basin. As example, I added those information, the length of the basin could be 30 meters, the wide of the basin 20, and the height of 5 meters. The total volume of that basin is 3000 cubic meter. So in order to select the right pump, we want to know what is the expected flow rate, the incoming flow rate into the first basin. So, and what is the flow rate, what the customer or the operator want to transport out of the basin. That means depending on that info, we need to calculate the min level and the max level in the basin. First of all, to avoid a kind of slurping conditions on the pump. This will save the operating conditions of the pump. And we need to avoid over flooding of the area of the basin. So what will happen when the selected pump is too small? Of course, you cannot transport or you cannot transfer the required flow rate out of the basin, and the area will be over flooded. If the pump is too big, then probably the pump will switch on and switch off more times than allowed per hour in the basin. So for that, if we have the incoming and the outgoing flow rate, then the min level and max level of the basin, we can do different other calculations. What is the time to reach the min level? What is the time to reach the max level of the basin? What is the net capacity between the max and min level in the basin? What is the time we need to empty the basin totally? So, and due to this, we can calculate the number of the starts and stops for the pump. Of course, we need to consider the cool down period for every pump to avoid any damages on the winding. So there is a short overview for pumps between 0.75 kV. We need to consider 6 minutes for a cool down period after switch off the pump. There is also another topic which is quite good. If the incoming flow rate is higher than the flow discharge flow rate, then we will get immediately an info there is something wrong. Probably the selected pump is until now not big enough or able to transport that high volume. Of course, for the calculation, we need some data to the piping, and of course, also information regarding the elbows, number of elbows, or any kind of piping accessories. So then we need the distance between two basins or two pumps, or between pump and plant, and of course the delivery head. Is it positive or negative? All those things we want to discuss with you or with your customer or with the operating company in order to understand what will happen at site. As you can see, this is in order to understand the whole system. This is quite important to us because of sustainability of the pumps and reliability, and in order to prevent damages on the pump and to have a high number of availability to reduce wear on the pumps, et cetera, et cetera. This is our focus. And then I will come to, or this brings me to an existing installation. This is the installation, a construction site, where we actually did this kind of engineering work, where we installed a series application to transfer bentonite for a slurry wall excavator. There is a pump installed in the pit where the excavator is moving up and down. And this first pump transfer loaded bentonite to the booster pump. We can see here. And the booster pump transfers the loaded bentonite to the water treatment plant. And after that, the cleaned bentonite will be transported back to the slurry wall excavator. So, and this is the installation we did a few months ago with a special frame in order to handle and to lift the booster pump very easy. And next we will see a short video regarding the internal leakage test of the Tsurumi booster adapter. We can install nearly to every Tsurumi pump. The result was excellent without any impact on the pump performance. So then let's start the video. So we can see here that whole system is complete leakage free, and the pump performance is as should be, as without booster adapter. So I want to a little bit make it faster because it takes plenty of time to get to the last step. But the test results says that everything is okay and without any impact. So in this step, this is another internal, one more. Last but not least, this is a short demonstration of the function test with a feeding pump in the basin. We started the booster, the second pump, means that booster pump first in order to illustrate that there is a feeding pump installed in the basin. So, and this is how it is, looks like. Now we start the booster pump, and you can see here that there is still no water transfer. And in a few seconds, the first pump or the feeding pump is started. And this is the booster application or series application, how it is installed in that construction site we have seen before in the pictures. So, and this brings us to the end of today's webinar. I hope you enjoyed our today's topic, and we hope that this could update your skills regarding pump selection. And now I want to wish you a very nice weekend and see you next time. Bye-bye.